Hey there, hello, I'm Hossein, and guess what? This is the very first episode of our exciting series, Grasshopper in Rhino from Zero. In this video, I'm super thrilled to introduce you to the amazing story of Grasshopper, what it is, why it was created, and how it has completely transformed the world of digital design. If you're just getting started with Grasshopper, or if you're like, what even is that? You're in just the right place. So come along with me as we start from scratch and take those wonderful steps into the world of parametric design. Let's dive in. Hi, everyone, and welcome to my channel. This video is the first episode of the Grasshopper in Rhino from Absolute Zero series. In this series, we're going to start from the very basics and gradually dive into the exciting world of parametric and algorithmic design. If you're interested in learning Rhino, Grasshopper, 3D modeling, or algorithmic design, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you won't miss the upcoming videos. I'd also love to hear from you in the comments, especially how you first heard about Grasshopper or what got you interested in it. All right then, let's jump right in and see what Grasshopper is all about. All right, let's get to the main point. What is Grasshopper? Simply put, Grasshopper is a visual programming tool for Rhino. Instead of writing long lines of code, you build the design logic using blocks and connect them together. Imagine you have a blank canvas where you place logical components. Each one does a specific task. One takes a number, another performs a calculation, and another creates a shape. By connecting them, you create a flow of data and instructions that generates results instantly. That's exactly what we call parametric design. Instead of drawing a fixed form, we define rules. Rules that update the form instantly whenever a parameter changes, like height, distance, or quantity. To make it clearer, I always use this simple example, the same phone example we talk about in class. Imagine you're guiding a friend over the phone to build an object. If you just say, make a box, everyone might make something different. But if you say, make a box with a width of 30, length of 50, and height of 20, rounded corners with a radius of 5, and 4 equal grooves on each side, what you're really doing is sending parameters and rules. Grasshopper works the same way. You provide the parameters, and the system builds the form based on those rules. Then, whenever you change one of those parameters, everything updates automatically. That means faster workflow, rapid idea exploration, and the ability to create complex forms just by combining simple logic. Now that we know what it is, let's go a bit deeper. Where did Grasshopper actually come from? And why was it created? The birth story of Grasshopper. Chapter 1, The First Spark. Before Grasshopper even existed, a brilliant man named David Rutten had an amazing idea while working at McNeil, the company behind Rhino that we all know. McNeil was always looking for new ways to make its tools more powerful. David noticed how much designers struggled with parametric and algorithmic modeling. What does that mean? It means that every time they wanted to make a small change in their design, they had to rebuild everything from scratch. David's original goal was simple yet revolutionary: to create a tool that let designers work with visual scripting. Instead of writing line after line of code, they could connect graphical blocks to create a flow of data. This way, they could parameterize anything they wanted, and by changing a single number, their whole model would update automatically. Imagine that. How cool is that? Chapter 2. The birth of the Grasshopper Project. Years ago, this tool was first known by a different name, explicit history. Later, it became Grasshopper. Because, like a little grasshopper, it started jumping and growing. At first, it was just a simple plugin for Rhino, but David and his team knew its potential was much greater. With Grasshopper, you no longer had to start from scratch for every repetitive design. You could create a visual recipe, save it, and generate thousands of variations of your design just by changing the parameters. This was a dream come true for architects, product designers, artists, and even engineers. Chapter 3, From a Plugin to the Heart of Rhino. Grasshopper became so popular that McNeil decided to make it an integral part of Rhino rather than just a separate plugin. Starting with Rhino 6, Grasshopper comes pre-installed with Rhino, which means the incredible power of algorithmic design became accessible to all Rhino users. Chapter 4, An Incredible Ecosystem. Today, Grasshopper is more than just a tool. It's a huge and active community. Thousands of people around the world use it, and countless plugins and components have been developed for it. These plugins take Grasshopper's capabilities to the next level, from physical simulations and energy analysis to creating complex geometric designs and even building design robots. Why is Grasshopper important? Now that we know what Grasshopper is and how it works, let's see why it's so important and what it can do. In architecture and interior design, Grasshopper lets you create complex and unique forms, forms that are nearly impossible to make using traditional methods. From intricate curves and shells to organic dynamic roofs, all can be built with just a few nodes and parameters. In engineering and structural design, you can optimize geometries and structural networks, analyze weight and strength, and simulate everything before actual construction. In digital art and design, you can create captivating patterns, digital installations, parametric sculptures, and even digital fashion. All right, so like, let's talk about these super cool tools that will totally amp up your Grasshopper game, yeah? First up, we've got Galapagos. It's like the ultimate optimizer, right? It's all about finding the best forms and parameters for your designs based on these constraints and like evolutionary algorithms. Pretty wild, huh? Then there's Ladybug and Honeybee. They're like your go-to for energy analysis and daylight studies. It's all about that sustainable design vibe, you know, super important stuff. And oh man, don't forget about Kangaroo. This one's awesome for physical simulations. It lets you design structures that are like flexible or even dynamic. How cool is that? Seriously, these tools make your work feel so much more professional, dude. All right, so check this out. Besides that, Grasshopper gives you the chance to work with nature-inspired algorithms and geometric ones too, like Voronoi, Delaunay, flocking, genetic algorithms, and a whole bunch of other algorithmic models. Can you believe that? It means you can create natural and organic forms and networks that actually operate based on geometric or evolutionary rules. These tools and algorithms let you not only create forms, but also analyze, optimize, predict, and even simulate nature. All right, so the main point here is like, in algorithmic design, Grasshopper totally lets you define your rules and design logic in a way that's clear and like totally changeable, right? You can test your ideas super fast, spot mistakes, and really take your creativity to the next level. So in summary, Grasshopper and its tools bring speed, precision, and creative freedom, making you not just a designer, but like a digital and logical designer who can manage form, function, and analysis all at once, even forms inspired by nature or those complex algorithms. Okay, so let's dive into this, right? We're talking about some seriously cool projects that use Grasshopper. First up, there's the Morpheus Hotel by Zaha Hadid Architects in Macau. Like, whoa! The organic form and that super complex structural network, totally designed with parametric algorithms. Then We've got the Heydar Aliyev Center, also by Zaha Hadid, in Baku. Can you imagine those continuous curves and organic roofs modeled with grasshopper and parameters? It's just mind-blowing, right? And don't forget the Al-Bahar Towers in Abu Dhabi by Aedas. They've got this amazing moving and algorithmic shell system to control light and energy for the building. I mean, come on, that's next level innovation. How cool is that? Okay, so let's dive into this, right? We've got like digital art and parametric installations, which is super fascinating. So first up, the Serpentine Pavilion, right? It's all about those complex wooden or metal forms designed with grasshopper algorithms. Pretty mind-blowing, huh? And then there's the Parametric Pavilion from IAAC, which showcases these amazing digital installations and those dynamic curved shapes using Voronoi and natural algorithms. Like, can you even imagine how cool that looks? Now, moving on to product and industrial design. So check this out, a folding chair and parametric furniture. It's all about creating furniture that can change and adapt with parametric parameters. How rad is that? And let's not forget architectural facades. We've got building exteriors crafted with Voronoi algorithms or smart paneling. I mean, seriously, the innovation here is just off the charts. All right, so check this out. We're diving into some really, really creative algorithmic projects, right? First up, we've got these amazing Voronoi pattern installations. I mean, can you imagine? They're inspired by nature and like use this wild Voronoi algorithm. It's just, wow, nature and math coming together, right? And then, oh man, we have the genetic algorithm projects. These are like next level. They take forms or networks and optimize them with evolutionary algorithms. I mean, it's like nature's own way of designing, just optimizing things over time. How cool is that? Like, seriously, it's all about that blend of creativity and science. Okay, so like, why should you even learn this? So far, we've seen what Grasshopper is, right? And like all the amazing stuff you can do with it, like projects that are just mind-blowing. But you might be wondering, like, why should I bother learning it? First off, Grasshopper gives you this like super logical and systematic view of design. I mean, you're not just making shapes, you're actually understanding the relationships and rules behind those shapes. And like the best part, you can totally start from scratch. Even if you have like zero background in programming or parametric modeling, you can just dive in, you know, with the nodes and the visual interface of Grasshopper, you're learning step by step. It's like, wow, you can totally do this. Okay, so check this out. Thirdly, this tool brings speed and flexibility to design, right? You can totally test your ideas quickly, spot mistakes in a flash, and change forms on the fly. It's like magic. And in the end, learning Grasshopper transforms you into this super creative and logical digital designer who can manage form, function, and analysis all at once. I mean, how awesome is that? So basically, learning Grasshopper is like investing in modern design skills, speed, creativity, and a deep understanding of the logic behind forms. It's just wow. So just a quick little note before we dive in, right? For this course, it's actually really helpful to have at least a tiny bit of background in Rhino, even if it's just super basic, you know? But don't sweat it. I've got you covered. I've got a whole series of Rhino tutorials for beginners on my channel, and I've dropped the playlist link right below the video. You can totally follow along with those while you're taking the Grasshopper course, and it'll make everything way easier to grasp. Isn't that awesome? You'll be all set to understand everything better. So if you found this video helpful, like seriously, make sure to subscribe to the channel, yeah? And don't forget to hit that bell icon so you won't miss any of the upcoming Grasshopper tutorial series. It's going to be awesome. and like definitely give the video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and drop your comments below. I want to know what topics you're most interested in. You know, in the next episodes, we're going to dive right in step by step, learning how to build forms and get into that parametric logic. So stick with us and let's keep this learning journey rolling.